following that, I started getting these weird occurrences with the number 1111. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you do, you know, have you looked into much with the 1111 yourself? Do you know about it?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
I mean, to set the groundwork for where I'm coming from, obviously I've got a few like facts here that I'd just like to like say, because obviously it's the basis for a lot of my work.
Yeah, sure.
And obviously this number, this 11, this 1111 is it seems to work itself into a lot of things. I mean, predominantly the first thing is the universe itself, and obviously on the 11th of August 1999 at 11:11 a.m. there was a total solar eclipse that was observed through Europe.
Mm-hmm.
And if you move that further on the end date, December 21st 2012, the end date of the Mayan calendar, the winter solstice, which is when the calendar ends, is at 11:11 a.m.
So I've heard. So
obviously,
yeah.
So we've got this effect where the universe is ringing these numbers at us, you know, in accordance to consciousness and stuff.
Yeah.
And when you look at it in an astrological sense, with the, you know, the precession of the equinoxes and the 26,000 year cycle of the Earth wobbling through the 12 signs of the zodiac, we're said to be moving into the new age of Aquarius.
Mm.
And Aquarius is the 11th astrological sign. And so, getting further into it, you look at the numbers of 21, 12, 2012, and you add all those numbers up, and you get an 11. And then you look into the sun, for instance, and the sunspot cycles are 11 years.
Mm.
And basically everything that you can just keep finding these 11s out of things. And you could argue that you're looking for them, but basically when it's that amount of things within the universe, it's not like I'm looking for them, because they are there.
Yeah.
You can't deny that. And so then you like start moving into the numerology of it. And for instance, if you get 1111 and you multiply it by 1111, you get the number 1234321, which is a pyramid. Okay, so you've got a pyramid numerology that you can get out of the 1111.
Backtrack on that a little bit and take it a little bit slower for us again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, if you've got the time code 1111, and you multiply it by the same thing, so 1111 times 1111,
yeah,
you get the number 1234321.
Okay,
so
yeah.
If you imagine that as a visual, you've got a pyramid.
So yeah. One step up, that's number one. Then we have two, that's two steps up. Is that what you're going at here?
Yeah. So essentially, like, because you've got the 1234321, if you were to plot that on a graph,
right,
on an X and a Y, you'd have a pyramid.
Interesting.
So and the same decreases, so if you've got 111, you times it by 111, you get 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. You get a pyramid, whichever way you look at it, anything with a base of 1.
Interesting.
And so then, if you look at the 11 itself, and in binary, an 11 stands for a 3. So obviously you've got a trinity out of it.
Hmm.
Do you know what I mean? So if you were to convert to binary, it would mean it'd be 3. So essentially, then if you look at this idea of the trinity with it, you know, 33rd degree Masons, the number 33 that goes around. Obviously, if you turn that into the trinity and you divide 33 by 3, you get 11.
That's right, interesting.
So you start like seeing these 11s, as I'm saying. So then you move on to recent events and you get to September the 11th, 2001, right? And you realize that the building was stood like an 11. The two towers stood like an 11.
Indeed.
And then you've got 9/11, which is 9 + 1 + 1, which is 11. And then you realize that September the 11th was 111 days until the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And then you start thinking about the first plane that hit the World Trade Center, and it was Flight 11.
There you go, yeah.
Right, and the total number of crew on Flight 11 was 11. And then you look into it further, and the New York State was the 11th state of the U.S. Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and so then you start thinking about where September the 11th stands in year, as far as years are concerned. And September the 11th, 2001, stands 11 years from 2012.
Mm, yeah.
Right, and there's an author called Jose Argueles. He wrote that from 1992 to 2012 would be in a period of the time of no time, which was a transition of the ages kind of period in which, you know, basically world disasters and tension would be on the up and rise constantly. And this period of no time was 1992 to 2012. And so 9/11 in September the 11th, 2001, was 9 years from the start of no time, 11 years till the end of no time.
Mm-hmm.
So, synchronistically, it was placed bang on where, you know, it should have been. So then you start thinking about, was 9/11 an event that was either, was it as Jose Argelis would put it, was it an inevitable event? Sorry, inevitable event. Was it designed by the universe for it to happen as it did? You look into it further, and World Trade Center commenced building in 1966 and finished building it in 1977. So it took 11 years to create as well. So you can move on from that and forget all that for the time being, and then you can get to September the 11th in history. And on September the 11th, 1990, at 9:09 p.m., that's 11 years prior to 9/11, George Bush Senior made his very first speech entitled "Towards a New World Order" in the UN, at the UN. So this was 11 years prior. And then if you take that back 60 years, so you go back to September the 11th, 1941, you'll realize that 60 years to 9/11, that was when the soil was broken for the Pentagon.
Pentagon, yeah, exactly.
And so you've got this date, September the 11th, again running through this kind of, the nasty war machine of America, if you want to call it
Exactly.
that. And so then you basically, there's something that happened much further back in time than that, and there's a book written in 1981, and it was called The Birth of Christ Recalculated, and it was written by a guy called Ernest L. Martin, and he claims to have calculated the exact date of Jesus Christ's birthday based on celestial charts for that era. Basically, he's worked out with the famous Star of Bethlehem, which was, he worked out that essentially Jesus Christ was born on September the 11th, 3 BC. And this book was released in 1981. So, we've got another date there. And
That's, and I think that is, sorry to interrupt there, but I think that's actually a key area to why we potentially are seeing so many things oriented around the 9 and the 11 September, you know.
Definitely. Definitely. I mean, when it comes into other significant events, for instance, when you think about America and NASA and stuff, the very first like shuttle that got to the moon was Apollo 11.
There you go.
And then, for instance, in Great Britain, I'm sure I think it's celebrated around the world actually, but on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, we celebrate Remembrance Day, in which we honor our war dead, but it's on an 11/11, and it's basically the Queen and a load of other people taking poppies to a cenotaph, which is an obelisk essentially. So, little strange events going on all over the place. I
Indeed.
mean, talking about the Queen, moving into royalty, and this is where, I mean, I'll lead much deeper into royalty later on, but basically, if you look into the history of the word crown and the royal crown, the word crown was derived from Anglo-French word called coroon, which is derived from Latin for corona. But the year that the word crown, was first established was in the year 1111.
Really? That's interesting.
Right.
Huh,
So,
wow.
I mean, you can't just say that these are coincidences, all of these things that are kind of like connected up. And I get to a point where, at first I thought they were coincidences, but then you think, what is this thing called chance? What is it?
Indeed.
So anyhow, that's the groundwork for 11. And then this is where I mean, that was, I'd started seeing this time code 1111 on clocks and stuff, and this is when I started getting this flood of information. I don't know where I've been receiving it from, but I've been receiving it from somewhere recently. I don't know what it's all about, to be honest. But basically, sorry, did you say something?
No, I just wanted to say it's interesting, and to some extent I think that this is in a way information that wants to get out. I think it's kind of a self-containing awareness within itself, meaning that it is trying to reach out and teach us how things are interconnected. And I think that numerology and so-called coincidence or meaningful coincidence, synchronicity, is a perfect way to demonstrate to us that everything is interconnected. And I think that there are so many levels to all of this. So what we're beginning to discover are some of the most, in a way, actually obvious and very clear signs of this. But I would imagine that this is something that actually runs throughout exactly everything, if you have, basically the amount of time to study something or look at it in close enough detail, you know.
I mean, the thing with all the 11s for me is essentially, I come from the viewpoint, I believe in a mind before matter universe. You know, everything stems from consciousness. Consciousness precipitates matter, not the other way around, as scientists would have you believe it. And I mean, the way that I can, you know, kind of prove that to myself and hopefully to others is that, I mean, I don't mean to be crude about this, but when, for instance, a man is sleeping and he has an orgasm in the middle of the night, right, the process that has created that is not any physical action. It's all stemmed from thought.
Yeah.
And so if you think about that, then obviously that thought has then created the ability to create life.
That's
if
right.
If you understand where I'm coming from.
Oh, and yeah, so, definitely. Exactly. It's so, a very good
I mean,
point.
That for me is the proof that everything is a mind before matter universe. You know, you can create life with thought.
Yeah.
And, you know, so that means that everything that you're looking at essentially is consciousness. And that's my way of like kind of, that's where I come from with a lot of this. And given the 11s, you know, connected with the Pentagon and connected with the 9/11, like World Trade Center disaster and everything, that to me is indicative of someone else trying to hijack consciousness. I don't know what it is, but for me, there seems to be some kind of other side of things that are hijacking this number for themselves.